For over 1400 years, this was called the land of Hijaz. Hundreds of thousands of Muslims from faraway lands flocked to these holy sites in Mecca and Medina to perform Hajj, the annual pilgrimage, one of the five pillars of the Islamic faith. In 1932, a Bedouin clan by the name of Al Saud, that was ruling in the desert region of Najd to the east, annexed the Hijaz, leading to the creation of what is currently known as Saudi Arabia. Over the years, the number of pilgrims grew to millions. The Saudi monarchy imposed a quota system limiting the number attending from each country in the name of safety and logistics. But foreign Muslim countries accused Saudis of utilizing Hajj visa restrictions to serve political goals.
For the fourth consecutive year, Saudi Arabia refuses to give clearance to Yemeni pilgrims, even to receive official documents sent by our Yemeni ministry.
During the last few decades, it became more and more difficult for Saudi Arabia to insulate Hajj from the impact of politics. In 1987, Saudi security forces killed about 300 Iranian pilgrims during an anti-US demonstration which they staged in Mecca. In 2015, Iran accused Saudi authorities of complicity in a stampede that caused the death of hundreds of Iranian pilgrims. So, the following year, Iran decided its citizens would not attend. And since June last year, when Saudi Arabia, the United Arab Emirates, Bahrain and Egypt imposed a blockade on Qatar, Saudi Arabia banned any coordination with Qatari Hajj agencies for pilgrims. It said Qataris were welcome, but because land, sea and air routes were closed, Qataris found it difficult to travel. The absence of any consular representation in Saudi Arabia also raised safety concerns. And it's not just Qataris who've had problems. According to the French Le Monde newspaper, Saudi authorities threatened to reduce Hajj visa quotas to some West African countries with sizable or majority Muslim populations unless their governments cut ties with Qatar. And during the last few weeks, the kingdom became the joke of social media platforms when it granted 300 Hajj visas to its new ally, the Lebanese Christian Maronite leader Samir Jaja. Photoshopped pictures of Jaja and his wife in Hajj uniforms were circulated in the Middle East media. Under his leadership and in coordination with the Israeli army, Jaja's Falange party militias were behind the 1982 Sabra and Shatila massacre in which hundreds of Palestinian civilians were killed outside Beirut. With the blockade on Qatar still in place, Qataris and Muslim expatriates living there say they continue to be denied a basic religious and human right. Mohamed Vall, Al Jazeera.